This week, the Republican Study Committee, which is the largest GOP caucus in Washington, D.C. among lawmakers, sent out a memo instructing their members, you know, the Republicans in Congress, how to frame the supply chain shortages that we're seeing across the United States here. And those shortages, by the way, are expected to get worse as we head into the holiday season. And the RSC, in their memo, says that you need to make sure you blame this on those Grinches, that's actually what they called them, at the White House. Here's part of the memo. Many are saying the current supply chain crisis is unparalleled in American history. How did we get here? Bad luck? Nope. Bad politicians. The Biden administration caused it. And our job as Republicans is to explain to the American people what the Grinches at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue did to ruin Christmas. Yep. Busted Biden, right? He totally wanted to ruin Christmas for everyone. So he somehow, some way, disrupted the entire supply chain, not just here in the United States, by the way. This is something that is happening around the globe. Biden did all that. The guy that can't even get his own party to agree on a series of proposals that would literally help millions of people put their lives back together. They can't even agree on that, but Biden was competent enough. The guy that they say is not mentally competent, but he's still competent enough to somehow pull off one of the biggest disruptions of economic flow here in the United States in recent history. Wow! That's quite a stretch, isn't it? Problem is, these talking points would actually be worthwhile for the Republican Party. Because most Americans have no idea what this supply chain shortage actually means and what is causing it. And the very short, simplistic answer, which is not complete, by the way, is the pandemic. We have worker shortages. We have trucker shortages. There's delays in shipping. There's delays in getting, you know, parts and pieces over here to the United States from other countries to continue manufacturing. So let me try to explain what's actually happening with the supply chain shortage that, by the way, has nothing to do with the Grinch. When the pandemic hit, the economy of the United States basically came to a bit of a standstill. People were staying home. People were not commuting as much. People were working from home. And so, because of that, you had fewer people working in factories. And so the supply that was out there of everything from furniture to cars to consumer goods to certain foods, the supply that was out there was sufficient because demand had dropped. And as demand drops, production slows. But then, as those supplies, the remaining stock was depleted, production was able to just barely kind of keep up with what was needed. Then, when everybody starts going back to work, even though the pandemic's not over yet, everybody goes back, demand skyrockets, but production wasn't able to go back to pre-pandemic levels. So now, basic economics here, you have more demand than you have supply. You also have more demand than you have manufacturing abilities. That's what's causing the supply chain shortages here. And again, we do have a worker shortage. We have seen some of these businesses try to up their wages in an attempt to attract more people here. But you also have to understand a very important thing. People got a taste of a different life during the pandemic. And I know we have discussed the bad side, right? The psychological problems, the isolation, the loneliness, the depression, all of those things that people experienced and are still experiencing today. That is one side of it. And it's a very important side. But folks, there is another side. And it's an actually more positive side. People got to spend more time with their families. People actually got a little bit more freedom, even though we were in lockdowns, to do what they wanted to do, to find their passion, to reevaluate their lives. And that's what's happened with a lot of people. So once it was time to go back to that crappy job you hated anyway, a lot of people did simply say, I'm not going to do it. I don't want to go back to hating every single day, coming home exhausted, not having time for my kids or my spouse or my dogs or whatever it is. And so they did something else. So that does contribute to the supply chain shortages. Not to mention the fact that we have had over 730,000 Americans die during the pandemic. And you mean to tell me that losing, you know, 730,000 people, most of whom were workers, you're going to tell me that's not going to have an effect on the supply chain? It absolutely is. And not one bit of this is the fault of the Biden administration. Hell, it's not even the fault of the Trump administration. There's lots of different factors here, and not one of them has to do with anybody being a Grinch over at the White House.
If you can't get enough Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to subscribe to our channel for fresh video content 7 days a week. And for even more from me, you can follow me on all social media outlets, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Farron Balanced.